Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, in the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful. Respected viewers, brothers and sisters in Islam, may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you. Assalamu alaikum, hello and welcome to the 13th episode of the Treatise of Rights series. Today we will discuss the right of the mother. Regarding this, Imam Al-Sajjad Zain al-Abidin, peace and blessings be upon him, has said, "Then the right of your mother is that you should know that she carried you where no one carries anyone, and she fed you with the fruit of her heart, that which no one feeds anyone, and she protected you with her hearing and sight, and her hands and legs, and her hair and skin, and all her other organs. She was highly delighted to do so. She was happy and eager, enduring the harm and the pains and the heaviness and the grief until the mighty hand expelled you out of her and delivered you out to the earth. She did not care if she went hungry as long as you ate, and if she was naked as long as you were clothed, and if she was thirsty as long as you drank, and if she was in the sun as long as you were in the shade, and if she was miserable as long as you were happy, and if she was deprived of sleeping as long as you were resting, and her abdomen was in your abode, and her lap was your seat, and her breast was your supply of drink, and her soul was your fort. She protected you from the heat and the cold of this world. Then you should thank her for all that. You will not be able to show her gratitude unless through God's help and his granting you of success. A mother, just hearing this word, brings calmness and great happiness to anyone who hears it. This one person who brought you into this world after months of pain and agony, don't they deserve our utmost respect?" Imam Sajjad, Allah's peace and blessings be upon him, starts his discussion with pregnancy and describes how a mother suffers the hardships of the period of pregnancy and the pains of labor. This is the type of hardship that no one else is ready to suffer for our sake. This point is clearly stressed in the Holy Quran in the following verse. "We have enjoined on man kindness to his parents. In pain did his mother bear him, and in pain did she give him birth. The carrying of the child to his weaning is a period of 30 months. At length, when he reaches the age of full strength and attains 40 years, he says, 'O my Lord, grant me that I may be grateful for thy favor, which thou hast bestowed upon me and upon both of my parents, and that I may work righteousness such as thou mayest approve, and be gracious to me in my issue. Truly have I turned to thee, and truly do I bow to thee in Islam.'" The Holy Quran, chapter 46, verse 15. Moreover, in another verse we read, "And we have enjoined on man to be good to his parents. In travail upon travail did his mother bear him, and in years twain was his weaning. Hear the command, show gratitude to me and to thy parents. To me is thy final goal." The Holy Quran, Luqman, chapter 31, verse 14. The period of pregnancy is one of the most difficult times of a mother's life. She has to put up with many hardships from the time that she gets pregnant. She has to give a lot of her own energy to the fetus that is growing inside of her. That is why she gets weak and develops many problems during pregnancy. Let's go for a quick short break. Stay tuned. The most difficult period of a woman's life is the time of her pregnancy. As the fetus grows inside the woman's body, its needs increase. This consequently puts physical and emotional strain on the woman. This particularly occurs during the last months of pregnancy, when it's even too hard for the mother to sit and stand. However, the mother suffers all these difficulties due to the love she has for the baby that will soon be born. The baby that will smile at his mother once it is born. Delivery is one of the hardest to bear periods of a mother's life. There are even mothers who lose their precious life during delivery. A mother is like a carrier who is delivering the most important package with which she is entrusted. She must safely deliver the baby. That is why she must take all necessary precautions to safely deliver her baby. She must be very careful about what she eats, how she moves, where she rests, and her hygiene during the full period of pregnancy. During the period of breastfeeding, the mother must spend all her days and nights to fulfill all the needs of the baby. The baby cannot talk during this period. He cannot tell where he is feeling pain. His only language is that of crying, and his mother must recognize all of his needs through his crying. The cleansing of the baby is another very difficult task in this period. The mother must also take care of the baby during times of illness. The Holy Quran states that the period of breastfeeding is 2 years, as in the following verse. The mothers shall give suck to their offspring for 2 whole years if the father desires to complete the term. The Holy Quran, Al-Baqarah chapter 2, verse 233. In another verse, the full period of pregnancy and breastfeeding is said to be 30 months. The carrying of the child to his weaning is a period of 30 months. The Holy Quran chapter 46, verse 15. To this, there is a beautiful explanation. Once we subtract 24 from 30, we get 6. Could the period of pregnancy end after 6 months? The jurisprudence and interpreters of the Holy Quran have stated that the minimum period of pregnancy is 6 months, and the maximum period of breastfeeding is 24 months. It has been recorded that some children have been born after 6 months of pregnancy. We can also conclude that the sooner the baby is born, the longer it must be breastfed, so that this 30-month period of development is completed. In the verses cited above, we were instructed to be kind to both of our parents. Which of the parents has a greater share in the development of the child? The Holy Quran has given a greater share to the mother due to her efforts and role during the period of pregnancy and breastfeeding. Once the sperm unites with the egg to form the initial fetus, the parents have an equal share in the development of the child. However, the mother of the fetus in the uterus and carries the baby until she delivers it. Thus, she has a greater share in the development of the baby. Alexis Carl said, both parents have an equal share in the initial development of the cells from which other cells are constructed through successive divisions. However, in addition to providing half of the cell, the mother provides for the protoplasm that encompasses the cell. Thus, she has a greater share in the development of the fetus compared to the father. The man's duty in the development of the fetus is for a short time. However, the mother supports the fetus for nearly 9 months, during which it is fed by blood delivered to it from the mother's uterus. Because the baby is in the mother's womb for so long, the mother's psychological state immensely affects the child. The mother's physical state and what she eats all affect the child. Likewise, her thoughts and temper also affect the child. All of the mother's time is spent caring for the child from the moment it is born. Even a moment of neglect of the child by the mother might result in the death of the child. The day and night caring of the child by the mother deprives her of the necessary rest that she needs herself. However, the natural love for the child makes all of this bearable. This has been expressed by Imam Al-Sajjad, peace and blessings be upon him, as she was highly delighted to do so. Islam honors the mother higher than any other religion on earth. The mother, who is cherished that much by Islam and given all these rights, has a task to perform. She has to take care of her children, raise them well, implant virtues, and make them detest evil. Islam honors mothers so much so that Islam considers heaven to be under the feet of a mother. The position of the mother is so lofty that the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, his pure family, has advised us in order to go to heaven, we must serve our mothers. The Prophet of God, Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, said, heaven lies under the feet of mothers. Moses, the son of Imran, asked God for advice 3 times. God advised him to his own pure self for all those 3 times. However, Moses asked for more advice. God, subhanahu wa ta'ala, asked him regarding his mother 2 times and advised him regarding his father for the 3rd time. A man went to see the Prophet of God and said, O Prophet of God, whom shall I treat well? He said, your mother. The man asked, who else? The Prophet said, your mother. The man asked, who else? Again, the Prophet said, your mother. Again, the man asked, who else? This time, the Prophet said, your father. From this, we can clearly tell that mothers have more rights over the child than the father. We can say that the mother's share is 3 times that of the father's based on the above tradition. Even though the father pays for the expenses of the child, the mother has a greater role in the period of pregnancy, breastfeeding, and the upbringing of the child. The father just pays for the needs, but it is the mother who is always with the child and never leaves him alone and wholeheartedly attends to him. A young man went to see the Prophet along with his mother. He wanted to go to the front, but his mother would not let him do so. The Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, said, "Be at the service of your mother, since it is not any less of a service than going to the war front." With this, we conclude this episode. Stay tuned for another episode of the Treatise of Rights of Imam Al-Sajjad. Peace and blessings be upon him. Thank you all for watching, and may Allah hasten the reappearance of our beloved Imam Mahdi. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.